Traders, I just need to go. So, as you can see here, I'm up just close to $18,000, and actually with my open trade just above $20,000, because Beyond just turned green too. So I'm still waiting for Beyond, and as you can see, Beyond is at zero here, but if I'll close my open trades, then I'll be just over $20,000 or so. With Zion. So Zion is just playing in between red and green all the time. Hopefully it's going to make it. I want to talk a little bit about ZM, Beyond, and Baba, because they all have one thing in common, a very important thing in common, all of them. Let's start with ZM. First of all, we took it as it was moving lower. It was a beautiful breakdown right over here. You always need to short it just before it breaks down. We watch ZM as it came down. That's a nice cup and handle formation here. Here's the cup. Here's the handle. That was a beautiful breakdown. It came down nicely, pulled back up a little bit and continued. So that was a beautiful trade, but it's not only about the intraday. Is, as you usually know, the way I trade, I always look at the daily. In fact, I start with the daily. Look at the daily of ZM. And if you look at the daily of ZM, you can see that recently it crashed down. It had a big day down and then a continuation, a very nice downside momentum on the second breakdown day. And then 2 days it pulled back up. You know, I've seen some traders who are trying to make a living from buying stocks which came down very strong, catching falling knives. Sometimes they make it, sometimes they lose big time. Usually, when the stock is crashing down, after a while, it will pull back up. Taking it on the long side would be extremely dangerous because you never know when the next time that it's going to make the next downtrend, the next leg down. And tell you what, 70% of the time, the reason that drove it down on the first place is valid for another move down. So if you look at ZM and you're looking for the safest entry point to ZM, that would safest direction would be shorting it. You're not supposed to be looking for a long, definitely not a long for a swing trade, which some people do, expecting ZM, which is an amazing company, and even though the coronavirus thing is not over and then they're expecting it to move higher or whatever, they would go long. That would be a very big mistake. You should be looking for ZM for another leg down. So if you have an intraday formation in ZM, it looks to you just like we've just seen, it looks to you like ZM should move down, and you take a look at the daily and you start thinking about all the people that think it should move up and all of the people that are trapped in a long play that are probably going to have their stop somewhere along the way down, again, it's more likely to come down. Don't expect it to move out. The safest way would be shorting it if you have a nice technical formation. So take a look at the daily formation of ZM. Again, after a crash, let it rest. I mean, we traded this one too. We traded these two down days too. However, after a crash, you wait for it to continue coming down. You wait for a nice technical formation and then you short it. Now, same applies for Baba. Take a look at Baba. Here's the daily of Baba. It's the same tech, it's the same idea. It all starts intraday with a nice technical formation. But take a look at the daily. Again, a big drop that happened just 3 days ago, 4 days ago. Trying to move higher. A lot of people are going long here. Why? Because it's a big company. It's Baba. People think that they could have a fantastic long trade in Baba because it's cheap now and they can buy a falling knife or whatever. But they're wrong. It's likely just to rest 1 or 2 days like ZM did and usually continue to come down. So look for the first day to short. Wait until it recovers a little bit and then put it on your short list. Don't put it on your long list. Put it on your short list. Baba is likely to come down again. And then you expect it to continue coming down. Then you look at the intraday. And then look at this amazing breakdown formation that we found today. It was an amazing intraday breakdown formation. So it all starts with the intraday formation. I mean, you can put it on the long, on the short list, but then you look for an intraday formation and you combine both. Yes, on the daily, it looks like it's about to break. Those people who are thinking it should go long, they're usually mistaken. It should break. Does it always break? No. But it's more likely to break. So when Baba is coming down, especially when you see the S&P moving up and Baba is coming down and it has a beautiful technical formation just like that, and you remember the daily and it was on your short list and so on, so on, then look at this amazing result here. I don't think really I made my best in Baba. I have a 6,800 actually with my open trades, over $7,000 open. Traded in Baba, but you know, this is I could have done a bit more. I took my partial probably a little bit too early today with Baba, but nevertheless, amazing trade. Now you want to take it a look at Beyond, which just turned green. I mean, look at the same formation here. Look at Beyond crashing down a few days ago, and that happened, of course, because you know the news that came out, McDonald's being now another a new competitor in Beyond, a big competitor in Beyond. Then on the same day, in fact, Beyond already moved down, then rested another day and another day. And look at this day right now. I don't really know if it's going to come down today, but I'm prepared. I'm looking at the daily. I'm remembering Beyond crashing down a few days ago. I'm expecting it to continue. Does it always continue? No, but it's more likely to continue. It is under pressure. And then you look for an intraday formation for a short. So did we find an intraday formation for a short? We did. It's nicely in green territory now. I could click the button right now and have over $4,000 of profits, but I won't. I'm going to wait now until it comes down under the low. It looks really great right now. So the thing is, again, look at the daily. Have yourself, prepare yourself a list of stocks that recently came down, crashed down, gapped down, and then wait until they recover a little bit. Most people think that they're likely to move higher. Oh, now I can't, sorry, I can't ignore that. About to cover some Beyond here, mainly because I need to go. And another almost $4,000 added to my account with my open trades. I'm just over $23,000 or $24,000 right now. So Beyond finally gave up too. So you see, just make your list of stocks that crashed. Wait for the for some days where they recover a little bit, and then look for an intraday opportunity. Now remember, all of these stocks are coming down today when the market is gapping up today. And that's another indication here. You know, the market is strong. However, you could wait for the market to come down, because even if it's strong, it could be trending lower, gapping up, closing the gap, which is kind of what's happening today. And then look for an opportunity, an intraday opportunity to go short again in stocks that the daily shows that they are likely to fail moving higher. I'm just showing you three examples here, and you can take a look at Big C, the same story. So everything has to do with the daily formation and the intraday, and when you put everything together, you have a nice intraday formation, you already have probably 60% chance to succeed. It's a good intraday formation. That's what we do, technical analysis. But if you add to the intraday technical formation the daily, and you could start with the daily, have a watch list, and you could start with the daily, and you add the intraday with the daily, then you probably have more than 70% chance to succeed. I've got four trades today, all in green. That probably shows something, right? Probably shows that something, some system is working well. And that's the system. We just discussed that. We have a good example here today. And hopefully that was enough education for today. So thank you very much for joining us. Really appreciate this fantastic week. I had a fantastic week. I hope you guys had the same. And anyway, I really enjoyed this week. And looking forward for next week. And thank you all for sharing and joining. And if you guys on YouTube would like to give us a thumb up, we'll appreciate that very, very much. So just enjoy a great weekend, everyone. And see you all next week. And don't forget the Top Trader course, which starts today. So just enjoy that too. Thank you all for participating. See you all next week. Bye. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.